Hi friends, in this video let us see the compensation theorem. Compensation theorem means if suppose suddenly in any circuit the resistance is increased or the resistance is changed, then definitely there is a current passing through the resistance and that current will change, and the change in current would be obtained. The change in current can be obtained by simply placing the voltage source in series with that resistance, and that voltage source value should be the current into the change in resistance. That will be explained now. Just see here, any circuit can be transformed into Thevenin equivalent circuit. So let me take directly the Thevenin equivalent circuit here. This is my circuit, Thevenin equivalent circuit. So this is VTH and this is RTH, and here this is my resistance R or RL. Let me take it as R only. If suppose this circuit has been changed into, obviously the current, let me take the current as I, and suppose this current, this resistance has been changed, so into R plus delta L. For example, obviously this is VTH, these two are VTH and RTH only, but there is a change in current here. The current is changed to I dash. Now I need to find the change, how much change has occurred. This can be obtained by taking the voltage source called compensation voltage in series with the resistance and change in resistance by replacing all other sources by their internal resistances or impedances. So this is the concept. So this would be my change in current delta I. Okay, this is the change in current. So now I want to identify what is value of VC. That's what my job is. So let me see. First, according to this, what is current I? I is equal to VTH divided by R plus RTH according to Ohm's law. Very simple concept. So it is I dash now in this circuit. I want VTH divided by R plus delta R plus RTH. Okay, this is the concept. Now I want to see change in current delta I. It should be I minus I dash, which is equal to VTH divided by R plus RTH minus VTH divided by R plus delta R plus RTH, which is equal to, the LCM would be R plus delta R plus RTH. So it is VTH into R plus, into R plus RTH. So the total should be the LCM. So into delta R plus RTH minus, for this it should be VTH into R plus RTH. So VTH into R, VTH into R will go cancel, and VTH into RTH, VTH into RTH will go cancel. So finally the result is, which is equal to VTH into delta R divided by R plus delta R plus RTH into R plus RTH. As we know, VTH divided by R plus RTH is equal to capital I into delta R divided by R plus delta R plus RTH. So this is the thing. But here, if you see the current over here, you can take in a reverse direction also. If you take current here, So what is current here? VC current delta I is equal to VC divided by RTH plus R plus delta R. Here it should be minus VC, as if VC is giving the current, the direction should be like this, but we are observing the current in this manner. So it should be, there should be one minus here. So it is simply that compensation theorem means we need to find the change in current by placing the voltage, ideal voltage source, in opposition with the effect. So the effect is, current is flowing in this direction. So we need to place VC in this direction. So VC will give the current in this direction. That's what we need to observe here. So by observing this part and this part, we can say that therefore VC is equal to I times of delta R. Now this is my VC. So how much voltage I need to place there is the current previously passed into the resistance added extra. So the change in resistance we can call it as. So now I can define compensation theorem. Now the compensation theorem is, if in any circuit if the resistance is changed, definitely the current passing through that resistance will be changed, and the change in resistance can be identified by placing one ideal voltage source which is having the current previously passed into the resistance added extra. That means the extra resistance, and that much voltage we need to provide here in series with the total resistance R and delta R by replacing all internal all sources, all active sources by their internal resistances. So this is the compensation theorem. If you have any doubts in this, please write in the comment box so that I will give you the reply. And if you like this video, please like it. If you want to share this video with your friends, please share it. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you so much.